Wofford College is headed for March Madness after taking the Southern Conference title for the first time. And it's clear Wofford isn't the only winner here. News 4's Mike McCormick is live on the Wofford campus. Mike, who's the other winner?
Well, Carol, people tell me they hope it'll be the city of Spartanburg. And while Wofford's win could be a chance to say, go Terriers, it could also be a chance to say, go Spartanburg.
I've heard a lot about it. I know everybody's been talking about it.
The game was good. I thought they played well.
Whoop, I'm glad we won.
On campus, basketball is the buzz.
My religion teacher addressed it.
By beating Appalachian State in Charlotte Monday, the Wofford Terriers became Southern Conference champs for the first time. With that comes an automatic bid to the NCAA men's basketball tournament in March.
I think everybody's kind of nervous to see where they're going.
The point is, people will be watching, and that's huge for this school.
Being from Delaware, I always say, oh, I go to Wofford College, and nobody has ever heard of Wofford College.
And the city it's in.
You don't get this all the time. It's a wonderful opportunity for us.
The Convention and Visitors Bureau is hoping the game will leave the audience wanting to know more about Spartanburg.
We want to make sure that they come and visit.
The game is the bait. Posts on the city's Facebook and Twitter pages could be the hook.
We've already talked to our web providers about putting some stuff up.
It's called basketball, but around here, opportunity is the name of the game.
This will definitely help kind of put it on the map a lot, I think.
Just cheer us on.
Good luck. Go Terriers.
All right, and so the Terriers merchandise is apparently in high demand. I talked with a bookstore here on campus today, and they say today they got flooded with calls from people wanting to know when the championship merchandise would be coming in. We're told the first shipment is expected sometime later this week. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in Spartanburg.